All the buildings on the street were dark except for one. The door of that was lit by searchlights. The street in front was empty all the way to the end of the block. Then there was a barricade. And behind the barricade was a crowd of silent people and a SWAT team, all staring at the brightly lit door. I was on the roof across the street. I was looking at the door too, only I was looking at it through a telescopic sight. The crosshairs intersected at head level. Behind the door, inside, was a terrorist with a gun, holding a hostage. I knew the terrorist. I'd been after him for several years. I'd almost gotten him twice. Each time he disappeared. Now he'd finally surfaced again, and this time I would get him. I'd been sitting here for 5 hours with my eye glued to the sight, focused on the target, ready to strike at the exact moment. There was a bullet in the rifle that would explode on impact, and I could place it anywhere on the target with the precision of a surgeon. A voice crackled over the walkie-talkie saying the chief was going in to lead the hostage and the terrorist out. When the terrorist came into view, he was mine. I watched the chief go in and close the door behind him. I made sure the sights were perfect for the 100th time. I shook my hand out so it wouldn't cramp. The sky up above was dark, the street below was silent. The only light was the light glaring on the door. Then the door opened. The chief took 2 steps and stopped. I could see the hostage behind the chief and a piece of the terrorist behind the hostage. The chief started yelling. I couldn't make out what he was saying. He was too far away. Then the voice crackled over the walkie-talkie again, saying the terrorist knew I was on the roof and would not come out until I had dropped my weapon down into the street and stood up to show myself. A feeling of rage ran through me because I thought I'd lost him again. Suddenly the rage disappeared, and I settled into that quiet place where everything is clear and possible, and I knew what I had to do. I took a bead on the chief and pulled the trigger. He dropped. I zeroed in on the hostage and fired. He dropped. And there stood the terrorist. Exposed, looking up at me, not believing what I'd just done. In that instant, I pulled the trigger and inserted a bullet between his eyes. His head exploded, and my job was done. It was only then I stood up and dropped the rifle. Then I turned and walked off the roof, down the stairs, out the door, and into the alley. There was pandemonium out in front. I quickly made my way through a series of alleys to the street where I lived. I went in my building and up to my apartment. I closed the door behind me, breathed a sigh of relief, and took a drink of water. Then I began taking off my hands. I put them in the top drawer. I removed my feet and put them into the closet along with my legs. I put my head in a box and hung my torso up on a hanger. Then I walked out of the apartment, climbed up the stairs to the roof. I opened the door and stepped out into a beautiful green meadow. The birds were singing, the sky was blue. There were flowers running through the hill. And down there, running through the middle of the meadow, was a brook. And seated on the edge of the brook, dangling their feet in the water, was the chief, the hostage, and the terrorist. I waved hello and ran down to greet them. We shook hands all around and had a few laughs. Then they started in on me. You can't do that. You can't shoot the good guys to get the bad guy. It's not fair. That's cheating. It's against the rules. I said, what rules? There aren't any rules. I won. But I'll tell you what. The next time we do this, I'll be the hostage. And I'll still win.